Okay, so I know the video is gonna start off a little weird, and that's because I had to delete the first two clips of the video because I didn't have enough memory, and I bought a new memory card, as you know, that's why I'm recording right now. But this is already like whenever like the finished product is done, you know, me installing the carbon fiber trunk. So I just really wanted to say something, guys. I haven't posted a video in about almost a month or something like that. It's been really crazy in Houston. We had Hurricane Harvey and it damaged a lot of stuff. Good thing that my neighborhood wasn't that bad, but it was really bad, you know. Some other neighborhoods were really bad. Streets were really flooded. I couldn't get to work. I was stuck at work for like almost 3 days, and it was just really crazy. I didn't have time to do anything. I had to help my neighbors. I had to help a lot of people, and I didn't record anything at all. I just felt like it was something personal, and I just didn't want to put it out there. So I didn't have time to edit. It was just really crazy for Houston. So what I really want to say is that I apologize for everything, but you know, it was really crazy. So I had to take like just a little bit off, but you know, I'm back now. I'm about to show you the trunk, and I know, like I said, the video's gonna start off crazy. It's gonna start off a little weird, you know, because I went to Kevin's house and he was the one helping me install the trunk. So like I already have removed the cover, but it was really easy, you know, it just clips and it comes right off. Then it's about to start raining. But before it starts raining, let me just show you the ending product, and well, hope you like the trunk. Remember, you could get this trunk at R1 Auto Works. I think it goes for like around $600-$700. I can't really remember, but I got the trunk off some guy and it was like really cheap, so I couldn't miss on this item. And you know, I'm just really happy that I got it, and I like the product, dude. Like, it's really good. I always wanted a carbon fiber duckbill trunk, but you know, it's really good. And well, let me just go ahead and show you. Okay guys, so I'm back at home and Kevin went to his house, whatever. Well, I was at his house, but I came home because what we couldn't do was remove this, you know, the screw. So what we did was that my dad, he got the grinder and he grinded off the screw. And as you can see, let me see if I can zoom in a little bit more. As you can see, the screw is gone. Like I said, my dad, he grinded it off, and now like literally this thing is loose, so it comes out right off. So we should be good now. Now I could just remove all the screws out and install the hood. I have the trunk outside. I know it's carbon fiber and I have it on this mat, but I don't know, like really, I don't know where else to put it at without scratching it. But what I did notice is that I try to put this thing on because I know I'm gonna keep this little cover, whatever, but some of the holes are not even drilled, you know, for it to stay there. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to get a drill and just drill the holes and try not to freaking break the carbon fiber. But okay, like this part, you know, I actually want this back. So, because I don't want that thing to be hanging around. That's the thing to pull out so you can, you know, open the trunk. But I'll make sure I draw those two. And I actually have this. See, that's like perfect size. So I'm gonna do that really carefully and try not to break the freaking carbon fiber. Okay, so that should be all, and now I'm gonna be able to put the cover back on and put everything back in. So now it's just reassembly. Probably wondering why am I doing this by myself, but like I don't have anybody else right now. So I'm gonna try to do this real quick and then I'll get back to y'all whenever like I'm done installing it. All right guys, so now that I installed the trunk, I'm just gonna put everything back together, and I'm gonna try to see if I can do it, because to be honest, all these things are like, I should have taken a picture before, but I forgot. So let's just try to figure it out. I know all these cables go through here and they come out to the right here, but that's gonna be the hard part. So this is what I'm doing. I got a piece of tape. I'm gonna tie everything up. And pull it up. Okay, so as you can see, it has the two holes. And this one has the two holes, which is this one and this one. But this one has this little clip and this one doesn't. So now, as you can see, I could be scratching, so I might have to drill a little hole in there. So now you remember the two little holes I made? Well, they're for this little two clips. And, but I think I'm gonna install that whenever I install the cover. I just gotta make sure it closes. So the moment of truth. So what you think, guys? I mean, just take a look at this. It looks so good. Let's keep going with the install. I'm not done yet at all. How the hell am I supposed to open it now?
Wow. Ah, damn. I messed up really bad.
That's so cool. To be honest, guys, before you do an install on something, always take a picture of it, because to be honest, I don't even know what to do right now. I'm pretty lost. So let me just go ahead and, I guess, install this one. All right, guys, as you can see, everything is back together. That little cum stain right there, I don't know why. More cum stain, but yeah, guys, like I said, everything is back together. It was really easy, to be honest. The only thing hard was the screws was really hard to take off. Well, the last one was, but I guess I just got lucky with the first three. But everything else was pretty simple. The only thing that I don't like is the way it fits. Like, as you can see, I can literally see everything. Still, I don't know if water's gonna get inside, but I really need to go get that fixed. Probably take it to a friend, maybe he knows. Like, this one is not that bad. And I mean, like I said, it's aftermarket, it's not an OEM. So tomorrow I'll just wake up and I'll show you like the results on the daylight, because apparently it took me a long time to do this. That's because of the screws. And I just hope y'all like this trunk, and I will see you tomorrow in the morning. So as you can see, it's so freaking good. The fitment, I still gotta fix it. As you can see, this one's good, but this one's showing a little too much. I'm gonna have to take it to somebody so they can fix it. And I already got bird stains, freaking birds. But yeah, guys, this is the finished product and it's really good. I like it so much. So I really recommend it, guys. You could either get a carbon fiber or not, but I prefer carbon fiber. I don't know why. It's just really light too. I can literally pick this up real easily. Yeah, guys, this is the ending product and I hope you like it. But yeah, guys, like I said, I'm gonna go back to editing the video, and I just want to say thank you for the support. Thank you for being like really patient with me of not posting a video, but I really appreciate everything you do for me, guys, and thank you for just supporting me. I hope you like the video. Give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, like, any questions, and don't forget to subscribe. If you're new, subscribe to this channel. Hopefully I'll be posting more, and I mean, hopefully I could, you know, start making better content, because I know it's a little bit boring. I apologize for that. Oh, and by the way, before I forget, the connections and everything, it was really simple. just remember to take a picture before you uninstall something, because I really needed the help. But I had a friend come over and he just removed his back cover, and I easily installed everything else. But yeah, the connections are really simple. Everything's really simple. The thing is that the screws are really hard to take off since it's a really old car. Just remember, don't put them back on. Go buy different screws. And you can literally get them at AutoZone. I got some at AutoZone for like $4. But yeah, guys, like I said, thank you for watching, guys. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. And I will see you later.